Hey, what's up, you guys? Welcome to Mahogany Sweets. Please like and subscribe if you like the video and want to subscribe. But I wanted to come and talk to you guys about what's going on right now. DaBaby has dropped his second album called DaBaby on Baby Number 2, right? Because it's the second album. And he's got a song called Boogeyman where he reveals that he has sex with Meg Tha Stallion. So, first, I'm going to just tell y'all the lyrics and everything, and then I'm going to give y'all my opinion about all of it, because y'all might not care about my opinion, but just want to hear what he said. So, let me get into that, and I'm going to let y'all hear a bit of the song. Okay, so, he starts this song this way, because I needed to hear what he said before, as well as after he said this, to have a well-rounded opinion about it. But anyway, so he starts the song saying, "You play with me, that shit was childish. The day before she said that Tory Lanez shot her, I was fucking on Meg Tha Stallion. Waited to say that shit on my next album. Hit it the day before too, but I kept it player. I ain't say nothing about it. Had her pretty boyfriend tweeting me, ready to die about the bitch like a coward. I told you N-words don't play. Now you gonna have to handle me. Now you gonna have to handle me. I poked the mother effing bear. I'm an animal." So that is what he said. That is all in the first verse. He starts it off with this. And my thing is, I believe him. I think it's the same with Tory Lanez. We all know what happened, but there is no proof, and she would never admit it. So, if y'all recall, back when she did the record with him, they did a record together. It was circulating around media. They were circulating it. It was getting numbers. People liked it. Then it showed him working with Tory Lanez. She was upset and offended about that. So she went on social media and, you know, took some shots at him. He took shots back. Her man jumped in it and took shots at DaBaby as well. So then DaBaby and him was arguing. And I believe Tory Lanez even jumped in it at that time as well, since that's who they were upset about DaBaby working with Tory Lanez after working with Meg, and she had just came out claiming that he shot her. So DaBaby whole thing back then, I believe, was he didn't know that she would have a problem with it. Pardi just the whole thing was, my woman upset, so I'm going to defend her. She's jumped out here, I'm going to jump out there as well. And they all got into it. And believe it or not, I was going to do a video about that and took screenshots of all those tweets, but don't even got it now. Well, I still got it, but I ain't about to go through and try and find it, since I didn't think about it beforehand and put it all together. But so that is what happened. That's what he said. Now, these are my thoughts about it. I understand why he waited till now. I think that during that time, he said, you know what, I'm not even going to reveal that or go there. Maybe even his handler told him, don't put that out there. And he just decided to wait, like he did with a lot of other things, and put it on this next album. Because that will be art and therapeutic, and honesty will be come on there. Also, if you look at the name of the song, Boogeyman, and the cover work, the album cover work for it, he tells you what type of time he's on. He's letting everybody know he got on this. Look at this. He got on this Freddy the Krueger sweater. He's sitting inside a chair in a black room, it looks like. He's showing you he's a monster, right? Boogeyman time. And that he's coming after people. That's what he's letting us know and symbolizing on this. And it falls right in line with Halloween that's about to be right here. But he's showing you right now, like, I'm willing to be the bad guy. I'm about to do some shit, and people ain't gonna like me. You know what I'm saying? And as well as sending out a threat message to people who he has issues with in the industry or in the streets, that I'm coming for you. I am coming for your next on this album. So, Pardi and Meg happen to be two casualties of that. Because he didn't just address them. And now this part is me kind of shooting him bail, and I'm going to tell you why. He didn't just address them. He just let us know what his art was going to be for this album. Or at least this song coming after people. In the song, he does go after other people. Them getting into it was something public, right? So this isn't like behind the scenes, her and him and her man all got into it. No, she addressed him publicly. Her man addressed DaBaby publicly. So he's addressing them publicly. Now, I do not like this bullcrap with these guys kissing and telling. They love doing this. But I decided I was going to shoot him bell on that too because he's not the first one. It has been done. Even greats have done it. Tupac did it. And they seem to always do it in a manner of trying to diss the man, right? So he's actually taking the shot at Pardi and somewhat Meg. He don't care about throwing Meg under the bus because Meg had came for him too. So he's using Meg, someone who he's taking a shot at, to also take a shot at her man. And a lot of them do it. Tupac did it with Faith Evans and Biggie Smalls when he told him, I effed your wife. Jay-Z and Nas did it with each other. I had sex with your baby mama and bleh, on the car seat and stuff like that. Who else has done it? You had a lot of them where they reveal in the songs. Oh, Drake has done it. Whenever they beef with a certain guy, if they have had their woman, they are going to reveal and expose that. They will even intentionally go after the guy's woman to have one up on him to be like, guess what, but I had your girl, right? I guess that is a very sensitive area for a man, so that's why a lot of these men go for it, take it. Right, Meek Mill, well, he name dropped, but he just said, I did things with Mariah, right? But what he was insinuating was sex. So I do believe him, because just like on set of these movies, as well, it happens in the music industry as well. They have sex rituals. They have basically like a christening of whatever collab that they doing with each other, whether that's a movie, an album, or something like that. They have sex with each other for some reason. And in some instances, it's payment. So I definitely believe him. It was rumored, if y'all recall, that Meg was up in the industry getting the reputation of being a easy industry thought, right? If y'all recall, they showed that video of her with Trey Songz in a club. And remember, her handler, manager, who security, whoever, wanted to hurry up, snatch, and get her away from Trey Songz because they were already having that problem of her sleeping loosely with people. And they wanted to nip that in the bud. They did not want her to get that reputation of being an industry thot with her something driving the boat with every damn body. So that's actually why they had snatched her from Trey Songz, because they was like, oh, nope, not another one. And I think that's also why they said, let us hurry up and give her a man to pin her down, and also to be in control of what type of man she got with, because they did not want it to be Tory Lanez. Know that as well. In the industry, all these relationships are not, oh, they fell in love, they were together and met, they got each other number, hung out. No, a lot of them are for their career. They are industry politic relationships. They are business career move type of relationships, whether for relevancy, for power, for it's like a situation like this. If they lonely, they need someone, they can't have with anyone, they pit them with someone that's in the industry that can keep them in line with the order, with the occult. So that's why they chose Pardi for her. They said, nope, she's sleeping around, she's busybody, and we got to get her with a one guy to lock her down. And we want to be in control of who that guy is. Pardi, that's who we trust. So her relationship, that's it was what that was, anything gonna wait. But from what it sounds like, that wasn't keeping her at home, right? She, whether she was sleeping with DaBaby and Tory at the same time or just one after the other, which I feel Meg, she probably looked at it as, I was just sleeping with that guy. I'm done with him. And I'm, you know, God, whatever going on with you, I don't want y'all two linking up, because guys talk, as we know and see, right? So she probably did not want them linking and talking. As well, though, is DaBaby, like I said, he addressed other things that happened last year. So music is therapy, it's art. And he probably said, instead of addressing all these things and all these people through a single, a diss record, or through tweets or posts, social media posts, I'm just going to wait till my album come to address it, which is smart and will be the time to address it. You can get it all out there. So that's the other reason why I'm shooting him some bell on doing this. He isn't the only man to kiss and tell. He isn't the only one to use it as to throw shots at another guy. And it is therapy. Music is the therapy, and that is not the only thing he addressed from last year. So it ain't like he just saved that one thing. I listened to the rest of the song, and he addressed and Danny Lee. He did not name drop these other people, but he even addressed Danny Lee when and talking about the women he got in the first one where he addressed her. And he talked about how these women, he's not dealing with no bad manner, disrespectful temper tantrum women anymore. They better be in line. They can't bring a phone or a camera up in his crib. He talked about how the situation that happened at Rolling Stone, how it took $30 million out of him, and they tried to give him a problem with the gays. But for now and on this album, he's gonna say what he wanna say. Like he states all this. But I want y'all to hear the song because I also, like I said, I like art, I like music. So I also wanted to hear the song and see if I like it. This tempo reminds me of, it gives me Lil Nas X vibes from one of Lil Nas X songs, which I like it, but. Man. See, I'm not gonna play the whole song and hopefully they won't pull it and say like copyright. He mad at somebody. Which I just told them about this. Boogie man. So anyway, I'm fine with the cadence that he used for his flow. I do like artistically how he chose a different cadence and flow for the hook. Completely. It does give me a little bit of Little Nas X remnants. From I don't even remember what song it is, but because it's a couple of Little Nas X songs that I actually did like. Like one was a Christmas one. I don't know. It was just something about it that I had liked from the beat and tempo. So I like that. I even like what he said. You play with me, and all of that. He gonna deal with you and turn the lights off, Boogeyman. So anyway, this was him addressing people he had issues with. He name dropped one specifically. Y'all tell me what y'all think about it. Do y'all believe it or do y'all not? Oh, and somebody on Twitter had said that they feel they feel Megan Thee Stallion cannot have a problem with DaBaby and claim that he switched up by working with Tory Lanez because she has switched up on plenty of people too. She switched up on Nicki Minaj. I tweeted that not only Nicki Minaj did she switch up, but she switched up on Carl Crawford. A bigger, better deal came. She got that call from Jay-Z and said, who? Carl Crawford, who? You know, so she herself, yes, has switched up on people. If Tory Lanez, what he say is true, she even switched up on him because he claimed that when it first happened and people wanted to know, did not know what happened, what was trying to figure out, her and her, she said, don't worry about it. Don't say anything. Me and my team, the bigger artist, she said, me and my team, we're going to handle it. You say nothing. And he said the next thing he knew, he listened. He didn't say anything. The next thing he knew, she was coming out talking about, I was shot and he shot me or whatever. So if what he's saying is true, she switched up on him. She switched up on Kelsey, you know, so if what Kelsey say is true, that she was sleeping with her mans behind her back. They saying she's a victim. She's done this to people. And also, believe it or not, people began working back with Tory Lanez in the industry. At first, everybody was staying away from him and like he was the plague, okay? And Joe Budden even addressed this on a Joe Budden podcast. He said, why is no one speaking about the fact that the industry has opened their arms back up to Tory Lanez? He said, Drake, for example, DaBaby. He said, these are two big, known, well-known artists who are all about public image at that time. Because we know DaBaby done did stuff to mess his up. But at that time, like these are the biggest artists. Their teams and stuff, they're not about to let them be around any negative energy or press and stuff like that. So Joe Budden said, he said, why is no one talking about the fact that the industry, these two guys who this will be a PR nightmare for them to be seen with, are willing and showing that they're working with Tory Lanez and being seen with him. And he said, no one's talking about it. And they're not realizing that this is telling us that the industry saw and know what happened, especially these two. And from what they've seen and know, their teams feel, who are highly qualified, capable, smart people, if you don't know how media works, because media is psychological, if their teams allowed them to work with Tory Lanez, they was like, no, something ain't right then with what Meg's story is, and they know something that proves Tory's innocence. And they're not saying it, but they're showing their support that they're not working with him again. They say, oh, okay, we can pick up back business with him. So Joe Budden had mentioned that, and he was absolutely right. People weren't paying attention to the fact that the industry that had turned against Tory once this first came out turned around and accepted him back in the business once they had seen and found out what truly had happened. And if you pay attention, a lot of people are either being silent, staying out of the Tory and Meg situation, or they're willing to work with him, which is them speaking volumes, saying that the man is innocent. We don't know, though. We'll see how this continues to play out. Tell me what you guys think about the video, if you think it's true or not. Thanks for watching.